Hello and welcome back to my channel. Last week I posted a video about SVGs and the shaper origin and like just very basic about like how to get your SVGs from different sites and so on. One viewer commented on the video and said, there's so many tutorials on SVG creation for shaper origin out there, but they're not up to Jenner yet. Perhaps you might do a video about how to do depth encoding in SVG using one drawing tool of your choice. All right, my lemon, challenge accepted. So when I saw that comment, I asked myself, how do you do depth encoding in an SVG tool? Is that even possible? So I rewatched the video of the Jenner introduction and of depth encoding. And the friendly fellow there presented four methods on how to do depth encoding. One was directly on your shaper tool. So you take whatever SVG you have and on the tool manually you go to every line and you set the depth. Not very convenient, but you can do that. The disadvantage, if you do it, you lose it afterwards. If you have a specific shape that you want to reuse, you encode it on your shaper, then when you reload that onto another workpiece, you will have lost that. So that's kind of not so cool. Another option was using Fusion 360 and like an export plugin that they have. That's awesome if you have Fusion 360, if you're a user of that, then that's obviously super convenient. But I dare to claim that most shaper origin users are not using Fusion 360, so might not be the best way to do it. Another option that they showed is using the files that you have on the shaper hub, because a lot of them are now depth encoded already, and so you can use them and then you have the depth encoding. But that's obviously only cool if you want to work with the stuff that is on the hub. If you want to do anything else, that's not really an option. And then the last method that they said is to use Shaper Studio. Shaper Studio, the software that you can subscribe to for a yearly subscription fee, you can go there and on the different SVGs that you create, you can set the depth and you have it there. And then you can upload it to your shaper. That's obviously better than to do it on tool because you don't lose this depth encoding that way. But it has a disadvantage that you actually have to pay money for that subscription. You have to have Shaper Studio to do that. So when thinking through those options, I was like, okay, but the files that are on the Shaper Hub have depth encoding. And if you download them, like the SVGs, they're there, right? And so somewhere in that file, there needs to be the depth information. But where is it? Like, how does that work? I have obviously no idea. So I wrote Shaper and I said, like, do you have any documentation on how to do depth encoding on a tool that isn't Studio? And they wrote me back, and it's in German, but I'll translate. It said, hey, Javier, depth encoding works with Shaper Studio. There, if you have the full version, so if you pay for it, you can do it. All right, Shaper, you want my money, right? Now, I don't have Shaper Studio, but I also don't think it's outrageously expensive. So I think if you have a use for that tool, it's actually a fair deal. So just let me put that straight. But I don't use it because I use other tools. And so I don't buy it because I have other means of creating my SVGs. Yeah, I was like, okay, how do you do that? I tried it out. I went into the SVG, I looked everywhere. I was like, where is that stuff? And I couldn't find it out. So I was kind of stuck. And that's when I asked a good friend of mine, Hynek. And he's like a master of computers. I learned a lot of the stuff I know from him. He's awesome. And I was like, hey, I explained to him the situation. And so he was like, challenge accepted. So he did some drilling. So I don't want to take credit for his work because actually everything I will show you here, Hynek found it out, not me. So thank you, Hynek, and the Shaper Origin community thanks you for figuring that out. It's actually pretty easy to do. An SVG, turns out, is an XML file. And in that XML file, you have all the codes, like the different shapes that you have, the lines, the coordinates, sizes, colors, all of that stuff is there. and every shape, every line has tags. And it turns out that what Shaper did is to add a tag to each line that has a depth encoding. And the Shaper origin, the device, can read that. And so after some figuring out, like we found, or Hynek found, not me, I actually am just reusing what he found, we found that with Inkscape, there is a super easy way to do the depth encoding in the tool using the graphical user interface, nothing complex. And that's awesome, because that means you have now an option to do depth encoding without Shaper Studio. If you have Studio, use it by all means. There's many ways to do it. But if somebody doesn't have it, Inkscape is free, you can download it, and you can do that. So let me show you how to do that on the computer, and you'll see how easy that is. Okay, let me show you how to do the depth encoding using the software Inkscape. Now, for the ones of you who don't know, Inkscape is a free vector graphics software that you can download for Mac or for Windows or Linux. So if you want to do that, go to inkscape.org. If you open Inkscape, you will see this tool here. And for the sake of this demonstration, I will just do a rectangle. So let's say we do this rectangle. And you want to make sure that this rectangle has a certain depth. Before I do this, I will ensure that this rectangle has the right color to do the right cut. So we have here the colors that Shaper Origin needs. And so let's assume we want to do a pocket cut here. So I will just make sure it has the right color. That's all. And let's remove that. All right, let's assume you want to have a cut depth of 10 millimeters. How do you do that? You click on the rectangle, then you go to the menu Edit, and you go to XML Editor. When you do that, you have here the XML file, the description of this rectangle, and you have here a lot of factors that describe this object, the coordinates and so on. That's not important for you. What is important is that you can add an additional description, like an additional tag, for this rectangle. So you do that by clicking on this plus, and then you have to enter the right nomenclature so the Shaper Origin recognizes that this is the place where the cut depth is defined. And you do that by writing Shaper colon cut depth. And the D is capital. I actually don't know if that's important or not. I never tried if it works, if it's not. And then in the value field, you have to enter how deep. And so here it would be 10 millimeter. If your depth uses like a decimal, it is actually using with a point. So you have to enter it with a point, 10.5 millimeters, for instance. So I'll remove that. 10 millimeters is what we want. And then you have to hit enter. Now this is in there. And what you need to do is to save it to an SVG, and you have this information in the file. So how do you do that? Obviously, you go here to save as, and we save it on our desktop cut depth. All right, for the geeks among you, I want to show you how this is actually stored. If you go to the file that you have saved and you open it with a text editor, you will see like a lot of code. This is the XML code that describes your SVG. And on the bottom, we have here the object that we created, this rectangle. And you see that here, there is this cut depth thingy where we encoded how deep this object should be cut. That's it, you don't need more. You don't need to do that step. That's just for the geeks amongst you. Like, you can just do it the way I showed it to you on Inkscape. Now that you have done this, you can upload this file to your Shaper hub, to your origin, and then cut it. So here we are on the Shaper. I'm loading the file. And as you see, it just loads. It's the rectangle that we created. If I hover over the line, it will tell me that 25 millimeters is too deep. Now you see, if I go into the depth setting, the pre-encoded depth is 10 millimeters. That's exactly what we wanted. If I choose a depth that is less than that, it shows me that this is fine, but it's not the right depth. If I choose the right one, it shows the right icon. And if I go to more, it will tell me, hey, you're trying to cut too deep. So it works perfectly. All right, that was it. Did you see how easy that is? Download Inkscape, open your SVG, do all the depth encodings. Is it possible to do the same with another tool? I'm sure it is. I'm sure you can do that with Affinity or with Illustrator. I didn't try it out because I wanted to find one way to do it. And so I chose Inkscape because I know that's free. And so for me, that's kind of like the basic denominator for everyone, right? Pick the free tool so I'm not asking you to spend any money and I'm showing you how to do that. If you're trying to do it with another tool, your tool of choice, look for an XML editor somehow that you can edit the SVG XML within your tool and you should find something. All right, that was my little video showing you how to do that. I'm pretty excited about that. I'm excited that Hynek helped me find this out. I think this is going to be helpful for the community. Please leave comment in the video. Let me know if this is something helpful for you or not. And yeah, this is the end of the year, so I wish you happy holidays to you and your family. I hope you're all safe. I hope you can take some days to rest, to recharge, to do some woodworking. Hopefully that helps you to relax. And well, talk to you soon and see you around.